I came back from Hajj. I had decided, you know, I want to take a break from politics. But my supporters, my workers, they convinced me that this election is not about winning or losing. This election is about saying the right things, fighting the good fight, fighting for justice, fighting for the truth. So my journey in this election as an independent candidate is a victory in itself. Whether I win, whether I lose, I hope to win, is irrelevant. But my foray as an independent candidate against the BJP, against the National Conference, against the PDP, in itself is a humble little victory.
Let me ask you one friendly question. You were to be the 2-3 LGs, even Governor also, Satpal Malik after that, Murmu after that, Manoj Sinha. But today your mood is looking totally different towards LG Manoj Sinha. Why?
No. My mood is very different. That let nobody assume that I am as spineless as the other politicians are. I am not here to be scolded or chided. There is no class teacher in this room and we are not pupils and students. If somebody has to personally harass me, target me, ask the police to harass me, ask some government department to selectively target me because I'm in a government accommodation in the middle of elections without seeking the approval of the Election Commission of India, I'm fine with it. But respect is a two-way street. Respect is mutual. There is no king in Jammu and Kashmir. We had a king, we had a monarch that ended in 1947.
Did you got any threat directly, indirectly, or LG administration asked to vacate this commission?
Of course, yeah. I received a notice that I have to leave within 48 hours after I spoke about the Baramulla conversion. That was a legally void notice. They bypassed, the rules of Section 4 of the Public Premises Act. Then another notice was served to me, which I have challenged in the court based on factual grounds. But you know, I know this is a government accommodation. We all have to leave this. But why am I being selectively targeted in Church Lane? Why aren't the others being targeted? Am I the only politician who lives in Church Lane? And why in the middle of elections? Why suddenly in the middle of elections? Why after I filed a form?
It is because you raised the voice when the girl had been
targeted. Yes, exactly. And it was conveyed to me that you have become a radical, you have become a hardliner, and that is not anti-national. If an FIR was registered against the Imam or Khatib of Dargah Hazrat Bull, then why did it pinch anybody when I spoke about a young Muslim girl being converted to Hinduism in Baramulla? Why should there be double standards? The expectation is that no Kashmiri Muslim politician should speak about these issues. But I'm sorry, do anything you want to be, do any damn thing you want to do with me. I will speak about these issues in front of the entire world.
But you compare LG Manoj Sinha with Putin? Do you elaborate it?
No, I didn't know that. I was going for Friday prayers day before yesterday. And at 1:30, when the whole, everybody knows at 1:30 on Friday, there are Friday prayers. The entire traffic in the city was stopped. Thousands of people could not reach mosques for Friday prayers. I saw school children. I have two daughters. The LG has children and grandchildren. I saw two children in a DPS bus literally faint because of heat. They were there for 25 minutes. Itna kya zulum kiya hai humne ki hamare bachchon ko dhoop mein basu mein sadna hai kyunki hamari sadke band karni hai kisi ke liye koi badshah gazipur se yahan hai. Kis liye? Have we not seen institutions, chief ministers and governors? Kab, Afzal Sahab, I ask you, when have our roads been sealed for movement like this? 25 minute pehle sadke band hoti hain. Aadha ghanta sadke band hoti hain. Buzarg hote hain, ambulances hoti hain, bachche hote hain, kis baat pe? If I don't speak about it, tomorrow, Afzal Sahab, your children will be in that bus. Will it be acceptable for you? My daughters will be in that bus waiting for 25 minutes like the children of slaves. Will it be acceptable to me as a father?
That's why you compare LG with Putin?
I thought that President Putin has come. Then somebody told me, no, he has not. They checked his Twitter, he had not come. I saw aisa curfew lag gaya tha sadkon pe, Juma ki namaz pe. Mujhe laga masjidon pe curfew lag gaya hai. Juma ki namaz pe jane ka haq nahi hai. But then I was told that no, President Putin is still in Moscow. And some other big world power has come to Jammu and Kashmir.
Why don't you align with Congress and NC? Because this is a big alliance. What can you do as an individual?
Why do you want me to align with the NC and Congress?
Just for the welfare
Congress,
of the people.
Yeah, Congress ka welfare hum dekh rahe hain. 1987, they rigged the election. 70,000 people died. Congress put Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah in jail for 18 years. We have seen that Congress ka welfare for the people of Kashmir too. We have seen what Congress did to Article 370 in way of 40 erosions, which happened from 1953 to 1975. We have seen Congress break the National Conference not once but twice. I don't know why the National Conference forgets it and why you forget it. As far as National Conference is concerned, ask the 70,000 graves in Srinagar if they deserve support based on sympathy. No, they do not. Yeah, they are not the repository of the sacrifices or the morality or the truth.
One and last, all independent candidates are getting the tag proxies, even the candidates of Jamaat Islami also.
Well, you raise these questions in every press conference. I don't know why you don't like Jamaat. How can they be proxies? Look at the injustices that have been perpetuated on the Jamaat. Abhi tak wo jo Amir-e Jamaat hain, the top leadership of the Jamaat, they were brought out of 6x6 cells just now. They've spent 6 years in jail. What right do you, me or Umar Abdullah have to call them proxies? To National Conference, every Kashmiri is a proxy. To National Conference, every Kashmiri Muslim is a proxy except the one who is aligned with their party. It's as simple as that.